What's going on? What's going on? What is going on, y'all? You got the almighty DJ CJ Flash back with brand new episode. I remember that song, and here to tell you all about it is my man. We call him the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Jerry Dove.
CJ Flash.
Yes, sir.
Dominus ominous. And let's be honest, you're the only one that calls me the man, the myth, the legend.
It's the truth.
But you're the only one. Let's just be honest.
It's the truth, man. Nothing but the truth, man.
I will take it and run with it. But you're the only one that does that, you know. How you feeling, bro? How did you hold it down in that wind the last couple of days?
Oh, I've been in the house, man. I battened down the hatches.
Yeah, well, that's a good move. I got on the was it the Richmond Bridge or the Carquinez Bridge or Richard Martinez? Oh my God! I said I'm getting right in the middle. I said it's gonna take a good piece to bring me off this bridge because it was horrible. It was like 27, 28 miles an hour.
Oh yeah, yeah. So I stayed in the house, brother.
That's something. Well, I'm glad we're all here now. We got a good show tonight. It's going to keep us all locked in, and I hope people will join us. I know there's some baseball on, there's some basketball on, but that can wait.
Yeah,
we're going to be here for an hour. We're going to have some fun. We're going to talk about New Edition.
Yes.
New Edition. And to help me talk about New Edition on IRTS Live, because I got my friends, we're going to sit around. We're going to talk about it. Let's bring them all in, please. Bring them in. Bring them
in. Get them with the Rick James, huh?
Okay.
What's going on, family?
What's happening?
The man, the myth, and the legend. I heard.
Okay.
It's
the truth, man.
Okay,
it's
man.
Truth.
Okay,
with
man.
An F.
What was they have? TROOOOOF.
There you go.
Truth.
Truth.
All right, Ryan Nicole, since you got the truth coming out, are you telling me what's going on with you? How are you tonight?
Oh, I'm great. Ronnie, Bobby, Ricky, and Mike is going on tonight. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to like do something.
No Johnny?
You know Johnny is...
Uh-oh. We're going to talk about that.
I know people are mad. I'm going to start the controversy early, but I can do without Johnny. Personally.
Ooh, do without him. Okay.
I could.
You took it right there. Okay.
I did. I do like fair weather friend, but that's a whole nother conversation. Let's keep it going. Who's next?
Okay.
Who's next?
She's been holding on to that one for a couple of days. Okay. Tracy Anderson, the CEO of Plush Life Media. Got the purple in the back. That looks really, 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 really sexy over there, Trace.
Oh, you know, I'm feeling some kind of way over here.
Yeah.
I'm feeling irie, unapologetically irie.
Nice.
Is that a Russell shirt or is that one of your own?
This is for the first time. Oh. It's not something that I stole from Russell.
Wow.
So how did that make you feel? How do you feel? Do you feel better about yourself this week?
I feel redeemed. But next week, don't judge me.
Okay.
It could possibly be one of his, you know, coveted shirts. Who knows?
You'd be white rocking this exact outfit that he got on. Yellow hat, the champion right. shirt.
All right, Russell Gabe Wood, one half of the world famous. How do you feel about that?
I'm just happy she's not naked. That's all.
Yeah, right.
Hey. It's always good to have options. And that you got the orange, the creamsicle again, because last week you had it on, we won, right? You had it on last time?
Yes, I did have it on.
Okay. It's okay. We're down 2-0 right now, but it's only the third or fourth inning.
Why would you tell the score? You know I'm DVRing. Why would you do that?
You DVR a baseball game, man? For real?
Yeah, because I'm working. Why? I can't watch it live.
I mean, but you can rewatch a baseball game.
Just forget it, man. Move on.
Okay, all right. I won't say anything else.
You're one of those guys.
I keep looking.
You are one of those guys.
I didn't know. I mean, I'm DVRing the Warriors game.
Whatever, dude.
I am. The Warriors game now.
So what's your shirt? Guy on your show who's wearing a Giants hat, who's been wearing it for two weeks in a row,
yes.
And you're going to blurt out the score.
I didn't know.
Game's not over. Game's still going.
Game just getting started.
There okay, we go. So, game's still going.
Anyway, what's your shirt? Did it say champion that you're wearing this week?
Move on.
Let me see your shirt. We got to see your shirt.
Move on.
I'm going to tell you, he's wearing a champion shirt. He's trying to, you know, build up the vibe so that San Francisco Giants end up as champions.
Hey. That's what it is.
I get it.
I see the poetry, Russ. I'm with you, bro.
I get it.
We here. Me and you, Russ.
Well, you got to ask him how he feels about Johnny Gill, and then we'll see where you both at there. So, CJ Flash, the music director of IRTS Live. I remember that song, and What's Your Jam? I haven't done a What's Your Jam in a while.
We've been missing those.
We got to get some people out there to sign up.
Mm-hmm.
So I agree. Make that happen. So,
I agree.
All right, so let's do that. You ready to do the show tonight?
You know, I am.
We are going to talk about New Edition and everybody that's connected to him. That means Bobby Brown, Rob Tresvant, Bell Biv DeVoe, and yes, Johnny Gill as well. You know, and there's some other things they got going on, some ABC, and here's Dante talk about my Jack. You know, Dante, I've got a picture of Dante in my phone that one day I'm going to flap it up. Next time he said something, I said, this is the guy who's talking about my clothes all the time. I got a picture, but I'm like,
I got a picture.
This is a guy Jerry. That's talking about my clothes. That's
don't pull him up. Don't pull him up today.
I won't do that. I won't
spare him today.
I won't do that.
Well, this is a good time to shout everybody out that's coming in to the comments. Shout out to Charles. We see you. Our very own Michael Austin. What's
hey,
up, bro?
No. Yeah.
You are the diva. We see you.
What
we
up,
see
Shayla?
You. And someone who did not give us permission to put their name out there.
But so, hey, fam.
All right. And shout out to Dante. So you guys, we are live right now on Facebook on the IRTS show like page. Make sure you go there and you hit like as well as join the exclusive VIP lounge. But more importantly, everybody say more importantly.
More importantly.
Go subscribe to the YouTube channel.
Yes. Subscribe to YT.
Yeah. And share, swipe and invite, share if you care. We definitely want to get as many people in here because we're talking about Ronnie, Bobby, Ricky, Mike, Johnny,
and all of them. Mm-hmm. I want to shout out my auntie. She signed up on the VIP lounge today. I want to give a shout out to her. Susan Gilliam, welcome to the family.
Auntie
Susie, you got
Susan,
it right.
Susan, you have to DM me your address, and I will send you a pin from the IRTS VIP lounge. A pin.
Oh, you get a pin. You don't even have to use a mouse pad. Look at you.
Wow. She's got to earn it. She got to earn the mouse pad.
She got to earn a mouse pad. Okay.
That mouse pad's
so how do they reach expensive. You, Jerry?
They can hit me up at Jerry Dove, GerryDove. Just go to my Facebook page, my regular page. That's fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
You can do that. Just hit me
in
the DM.
They can email you at where?
At gdub@irtsshow.com.
It's right over there. It's right there in his bottom thing over there.
Right there.
Yeah.
So he didn't say Gmail. It wasn't at Gmail. He's listening.
No.
He said Yahoo, AOL.
Don't do the Gmail. And by the way, the Hey fan was Belinda Davis. So that's give her a proper hello there, Belinda.
Hey.
All right, so CJ Flash, you ready to get this rolling?
Absolutely, brother.
Give us some New Edition. I had to turn the volume down on my headset when you start hitting them notes. I'm like, oh, whoa.
She actually did a body roll. I thought it was going to be like a group body roll.
We're not there yet on our group choreo. We'll get there.
We'll get a warm up.
Before the end of the show.
Who wants to go first with Candy Girl? Who wants to go first?
Oh, I got a story for that one. When Candy Girl came out, my cousins came down from Sacramento and they had the record. They had a really, what's the small one, guys?
The 45.
So they had the 45. I was a little girl and I had this Sesame Street record player.
Nice.
Yeah.
Did it go on the breaker board?
Of course.
Okay.
Right. How else was I breakdancing? But with the Sesame Street record player. So they brought the album down. We play it. We're playing it as loud as we possibly could in my bedroom. And my dad comes up to the room. He's like, turn that thing off. You got it on, you know, the high speed. Put it down on the slow speed. We're like, no, Dad, this is how it sounds.
Oh, my goodness.
This is how they sing. Yeah. He's like, okay. All right.
He does hit them notes. Like I said, when I had to take my earpiece out a little bit there, you know.
Right.
So I was talking to CJ before the show. I mean, I don't think his voice changed a whole lot, even to this evening. It still sounds like that.
He's very close.
I love you, Ralph.
Ralph, we love.
Hey, Tracy, you talk about Candy Girl. Where were you the first time you heard Candy Girl, Tracy?
Oh, boy. I was in junior high, I think. I'm telling my age. It's okay. And a friend of mine, Malik Levy, his father worked in the music industry. Oh, and they were from New York. And so he had just gotten back from New York. And he was like, oh, my God, I got to tell you about this group. They called New Edition and this and that or whatever. And so he played it and we just all lost it. And Malik ended up working in the music industry as well. So shout out to him. He's from the Bay.
Yeah.
But worked at BMI and did A&R at Capitol Records and all kind of stuff. So music was in our DNA. But that's how I learned, you know, initially learned about it. And I think New Edition was one of my first concerts. My brother took it too. So shout out to my big bro,
John.
Nice.
All right. Russ, what you got?
Candy Girl was not one of my favorites. It was, I was in big junior high too. And it just seemed kind of very, very kiddie. And I didn't really, I wasn't really feeling it. In my mind, I was older than they were. Hmm. And it didn't really click to me. It wasn't until Mr. Telephone Man that I started, hey, it's not the same group, is it? You know.
All right, Flash, what you got?
Oh, good Lord. So when that record came out, there was a same producer had produced a couple of tracks, actually a whole album prior to that and a few other songs. But Michael Johnson of the Johnson Crew is the reason that I listened to it, that I got tuned into it. Because I looked at the record in the record store and I saw his name on the credits. I was like, oh man, maybe this is something to boogaloo to. And I wasn't ready for this, but it was good. And and if you really listen to like Pac Jam that Michael Johnson produced, you can hear all of the same sounds from the drum claps and the snares down to the vocoder.
It's oh wow.
Pretty interesting.
Well you play a little, you got a piece of that?
Oh, I think I can. I think
give us a little piece of that so we can hear the difference.
Nice. Let's go on, CJ.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Turn that light.
Yeah. Same drum, same snare. Vocals.
Yeah. Yep, I get it.
Yeah, now,
when I first heard New Edition, I was probably already 35 or something. You guys in junior high school. Well, maybe not that old. But
damn, how old are you, bro?
That was a setup. That was a baseball setup for you. That was just a joke. No, but when I heard
I was going to pick up my Social Security check and I heard this.
On a Victrola.
Right,
something else.
Yeah, a little RCA dog was looking at me.
Yeah. Now, when I first heard them, I'm like you, Russ. I thought, okay, these are little kids, man. I can't, you know, get with the kids. And then I saw them dance. And yeah. I've always been partial to seeing groups that can sing and dance, you know. So so I paid a little bit more attention to them. And then they got me over the years. And as we get into some more of their more mature songs, then I'll talk a little bit more. But early on, it wasn't for me. It was for the kids.
And when we saw the video, they had so much presence and confidence.
Yeah.
Usually, you know, they build up to that type of confidence, but their delivery, you know, shout out to their choreography, choreographer, Ronnie DeVoe's uncle. So
was Brooke Benton working with it? Brooke Benton. Brooke Payne, was he working
How old
with
are him? You now? You're talking about Brooke Benton?
That's true. Touche, bro. Was Brooke Payne working with them from the very beginning?
You know, that's a good question. We'd have to look at the I don't know. I'd have to figure that out.
When we saw the video, that's when you kind of got a deeper appreciation for what they were. Mm-hmm. Because no one was doing, prior to them, the kids didn't really have videos. You would see them on variety shows, but they didn't have a video.
Right.
So when they came out with their video, like, okay, all right, I see where this is going, and kind of gave it a chance.
I want to say yes to the Brooke Payne piece. Okay. I want to say yes.
Well, Sheila Diva yes, Tennyson says yes, and it must be so.
Sheila be knowing.
Sheila said it, it must be no. So.
Yes.
A good one.
She be knowing.
CJ, give us another one. See, I was too old to take that serious. Y'all keep on talking. I'll jump in later. Y'all keep.
That was definitely.
They were still boys working their way up to be men. Just hadn't gotten there yet. So.
They were boys working up to be teenagers or something, weren't they? Okay, this sounds, that sounds yeah, very young.
Those are generally the steps.
Well, yeah, how did you think about it? You know?
That's how it works.
Man, I'm surrounded by these smart people.
I know.
You gotta be on your toes when you talk to this group. That's why that's why we never could get anybody to come in with us when we're doing the shows early
on.
That's
not true.
They're scared. Because I'm scared sometimes. I gotta
think
about this before I say it.
You know you don't want to say smart. You want to say smart mouth. I know you.
I didn't say that. No, because that would just ignite a whole nother flame.
You're right. You're right.
So I did not say that. I did not say that.
On and cracking.
All right. So
I do have a question though.
Go ahead.
Was that Ray Parker Jr. that did that production?
You know what? Not on that first album. I don't think Ray wasn't a part of that first album.
Ray worked with Michael Johnson and with. But more on CJ, Jerry Knight?
Jerry Knight, yeah, because Jerry Knight was in radio.
Yeah, with the Jerry Knight stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
Definitely. And you know, to Write On Magazine, because that's what, you know, my wallpaper was. Write On Magazine, pullouts of Ralph and Ricky and all of the, you know, Michael Bivens. Hi, my goodness.
No doubt, no doubt. I love that that song was remade, too. It was remade when I was in, I still might have been in elementary, but it was made by ABC, which was a derivative of that whole crew of New Edition, BBD, ABC. So Jealous Girl was something I heard for the first time when I was about 12.
Through ABC?
Yeah, through ABC.
I love it.
Yeah.
How about that?
All right, CJ, let's try another one here. Let's see how I can feel about the next one. All I keep thinking about. So now I'm starting to feel them a little bit because the video is out. You're seeing these guys dancing and the steps are tight and the energy is right. I'm like, okay, now they got my attention. Now I'm starting to understand the fascination with New Edition. Cool It Now was a jam, still is a jam. Russ, CJ, I'm sure you guys can talk about how you could play that anywhere, anytime.
Can you really?
Can't you? No?
No, really?
Really? I'm surprised. Tell us.
What?
No, man.
Explain.
You know what's up? Go ahead, Russ.
Candy Girl, yes. Cool It Now does not get the, it doesn't elicit the same response.
No. Is that right?
No, it does. It doesn't work like that. It's not a crowd pleaser. You don't get the oohs and ahs from that.
Wow, that's amazing.
People will sing along with it, but it's not
But even the Ronnie, Bobby, Ricky, and Mike.
Yeah, but you got to go through 2 minutes of of whatever to get to that part. Now people know all those, so you can kind of mix to get to that one point.
Yeah,
you kind of go into the chorus before the rap, and then you know that works. But it's not; it doesn't get nearly the response as Candy.
No,
that surprises me too.
Is that
because of the BPMs? You think, like, is it the tempo? What do you think it is?
I could say that because it didn't because of the the tone of that song at that tempo didn't match anything else at that tempo.
Yeah, yeah.
So it was hard to mix it in with anything, but it just wasn't, it wasn't, it was a bigger hit at the moment than it didn't have lasting power.
I feel it.
Mr. Telephone Man had lasting power.
Yes.
Candy Girl had lasting power.
Yes. That's real. Okay.
All right, CJ, what you got for
plus the, you know, you had the video where you had those glamour shots.
I know.
The got glamour shots.
And the shag.
Yes. And the, yes, and the shag.
Lord.
It, I'm not saying the song didn't work. It just it doesn't hold up today.
It worked for our age demographic, for my age demographic.
Yes,
anything that they did.
Yes, it did, Tracy. Yeah. It did work for you.
Okay. Anything that they did at that point, it was just like, oh, my God. So, yeah.
But CJ, what do you think about, so what do you think about that?
I will say that when the series came out, there was a resurgence. And so I think I was working at the skating rink. And, you know, you have a bunch of young people skating. Like, you know, real young. And their parents, of course, showed them the New Edition movie, told them, you know, this is what we grew up to. Mm-hmm. And so they knew the words. They knew the songs word for word. And so playing Cool It Now was like a big thing for them. They really, really, they would come up and request it.
Wow.
You know, yeah. Yeah. Cool It Now, Candy Girl, anything New Edition at that time when the series came out. Then that's what they were on, the younger kids.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Now you mean this recent series? That
yeah.
Was on
yeah.
BET?
Yeah. What was it? 2016? 2019?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's tight. Okay.
Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah,
yeah, mm-hmm. Me too.
So there was
yeah, they have a brand new audience from that.
Yeah.
Yeah. I respect it.
Because it went viral and all the kids started saying, okay, what is this?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Why are my parents embarrassing me in the living room right now?
Right.
That would have been a good time for them to tour. Unfortunately, I think they weren't really on the yeah. on the same no. page no. communication.
Right.
Yeah, they missed that two big first. Opportunities.
Yeah.
When they had the 30th anniversary. They already had signed a deal with Lincoln Mercury to sponsor a tour, and they were beefing and they couldn't get it together. And that was millions of dollars.
Mm.
Wow.
You know, and now they're not, you know, Ralph has his thing, and you know, it's just, it's hard with groups. There's so many dynamics with groups.
Yeah.
And we've seen it play out, you know, real life. We've seen it play out, but I'm hoping that when things flip around for summer of 2022, that that we'll be able to see them, you know, all of them together.
Yeah.
Including Johnny.
Okay.
Ryan.
Johnny can come. Johnny can come. He just gotta pull it back.
Tracy's got the song. See, that's it right there.
Growing up can be a pain. He was speaking because I was having a hard time adulting, right?
Okay, that's fair. I mean, you know, once I got to the Boomerang by Johnny, I was with him, but you know,
let's talk about it now. So tell us what happened.
What happened? What he do to me? I don't Johnny's like temperature compared to the rest of the group. Was just too high for me. Like he's a singer, and I have to give it up to him for that. He's a singer. He is not a pop dude. He is like full on R&B and soul, and that is not the vocal range of the group. So it was like to me, you know, bringing like a gourmet meal to like Chuck E. Cheese. You know what I'm saying? but we enjoyed our Chuck E. Cheese. You know what I'm saying?
Well, like, if I can be honest with you. I will say this, Ryan, that when he joined the group, he was trying to fill. He was filling a void, and people my age knew him as this kid artist, this teen artist.
Yeah.
Me and Stacey Lattisaw, and they had this thing. He had this amazing instrument where he sounded like a grown-ass man.
Yeah.
And he was basically an embryo. And he was able to, he was killing it. And, you know, people were like, okay, but he's singing things that are, the subject matter is older than he is, but he had this old man voice.
Right, right.
When he joined New Edition to kind of fill the void of Bobby, when they went into the whole 1985, 86, 87 production, it was, how is this going to work? Because none of these dudes can sing like this dude.
Right.
And can this dude tone it down to fit this group?
Yeah.
And it was only the magic of those producers that were able to make that work.
Jam
and
Lou.
Everybody embraced it.
Yep. Shout out to Lou Silas. Rest in peace. You know, he was their A&R and he had to kind of, you know, balance that transition for them. You know, I did have a conversation with one of the members of UTFO, Doc Ice.
Ooh, get out of here. No. Yeah.
And Doc Ice told me, hopefully I'm not going to get in trouble. If this was not supposed to be told, I'm sorry. But he was one of the people that they were considering to replace Bobby.
Oh, wow.
Is that right? Wow.
And that actually would have been a really dope dynamic.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now, I'm not listening to Johnny, right?
Yeah.
But that would have been an amazing fit because of his dancing ability, because of his rapping ability, and just his stage presence.
That's
so big. Yeah. So that would have been really, really amazing. And I'm gonna just leave it there.
That's deep.
Yeah. So what about the thought of how Johnny matured the group?
He did.
You know, he did. They could stop seeing the bubblegum stuff. And you know, some, by the way, speaking of bubblegum, I'm still getting comments on my pink bubblicious jacket from 3 weeks ago.
Oh, the Hello Kitty jacket?
No, I said bubblicious. I didn't say nothing about the Hello Kitty, but bubblicious.
It was your breast cancer awareness jacket.
I keep trying to tell people I'm wearing that for breast cancer awareness.
In September.
It was October.
Leading up to it.
It was October.
Okay.
But I think that Johnny brought them more mature.
He did.
And took them and grew them up.
But the album before that, they had, that's when they were doing the doo-wop covers, when they were attempting to make that step. Right. I don't think it wasn't the mature thing. It connected the dots between what they were capable of and what they were doing in a very cool way, because the way it was produced, and we'll get to this music later, I'm sure CJ's pulled all this stuff out, but what they were able to do is, because Johnny is like a guitar solo on every song.
Exactly.
And sometimes you look, dude, can I will unplug this wah-wah
pedal. Right.
One more game, bro. And these producers were able to get it to a package. They made a package out of it. Okay, what do you do well? Okay, what do you do well? Okay, what do you do well? Okay, sit back. I'm going to come back to the table with something. And that worked.
They did a great job.
Yes, Jim Jam and Terry Lewis. I mean,
Shout out to Big Jim, too. Shout out to Big Jim.
Absolutely. Yeah. So they knew they had a very complicated and intricate scenario, you know, both talent wise and personality wise. And I think they did an amazing job.
Yeah, I totally agree with you, Tracy. And it's only those guys that could have made it happen. Shout out to Foster McElroy. I don't think they could have done it because they didn't have that vision that they had. Right. Thank God they didn't end up with Jelly Bean Benitez. You know what I mean? It's just it was just that spark that, and it worked. It worked for their production too. Mm-hmm. New Edition did wonders for Flight Time.
And let me just say, you know, with Foster McElroy, if they had an opportunity, I'm sure they would have put out a really good song because they were used to dealing with really good vocalists. You know, with En Vogue and other people.
Well, this was before En Vogue. This was before En Vogue, so it would have been, and I can't say that they couldn't have done it, because it's revisionist history now, because I know what was done, and I know how capable those dudes are, geniuses. And if you ask me,
they really deserve.
We need to give them their flowers for sure.
No doubt.
We can get them on the show.
Let's do it. Come on,
producer. But I think maybe LA and Face could have. You know, in which they contributed later, obviously, but
too slick.
Well, we'll get to those songs in a little bit, but let me say this: shout out to all of you guys for the metaphors that you're pulling out here. Tonight to describe Johnny Gill and the singing of New Edition. I'm sure they've never been compared to Chuck E. Cheese and what you said
a gourmet meal.
A minute ago and a gourmet and something that Tracy said. A shout out to the metaphors.
and also, to the people that are watching, you guys share, swipe, invite. Tag somebody in the comments. Yeah. We want to get this conversation going.
Yeah. Yes.
And speaking of that, you see what Sheila Diva said. She's going to hire Johnny to sing at your baby shower.
Oh, Jesus. Thank you, Sheila. I really appreciate it.
That's going to rub you the wrong way.
You're going to exactly rub me the wrong way. I'll definitely go into labor immediately.
TJ, before she goes into labor, couldn't put another song on.
Mr. Telephone Man, there's something wrong with my life. When I dial my baby's number, she said, hello, may I help you please? I told her something must be wrong with my phone, 'cause my baby wouldn't hang up on me.
See, them young folks don't know nothing about the clicks on the
okay.
line.
Okay. They don't know nothing about clicking.
I don't know. They don't know anything about dial.
Yeah, right.
He did say
dial, didn't he?
Remember you used to have to dial popcorn to get the time? Dial popcorn to get the time. What was that number? Was it?
It was 767-2676 or any four last digits.
Yeah.
Okay.
Could have been any four numbers.
The time is.
Is that right?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Oh, see, you didn't know that.
I knew you could call popcorn, but I didn't know you could dial those other four numbers.
The tone, the time will be.
That's how we found out what time it was. We got a cell phone to look at.
Yeah, no, mm-hmm. I remember when the power went off, or when you know it was an earthquake or something. You call popcorn.
We used to do this too. When we had family that was visiting from out of town, they'd get all the way back home and they'd call and say, "I wanted like a person-to-person call for Jerry Dove," and they said, "Oh, Jerry's not here." Okay, I'm sorry. And then that's their way of letting you know that they made it home.
Oh, okay.
Back then, them long-distance calls cost every time you call somebody.
Oh,
long distance.
Wow. Look at
so
that.
So you would call and ask for them. They say, "Oh, Jerry's not here." And that lets me know that you made it home.
Oh, there you go. Mm-hmm. Mr. Telephone Man.
Yes. But back to the song.
So Jerry, tell us more about the pickle barrel phone.
Well,
if you had it at the general store.
You know what? I got all these phones.
House on the prairie.
I got all these phones in my closet that I've kept from over the years, you know. So cool. I don't know what I'm going to do with them. But one day somebody's going to want some old phones, and I got them.
There you go.
All these push button phones and rotary phones avocado green and all that stuff, man.
You can put them all in the station wagon and drive back down to Bug Tussle and sell them right down there to Cousin Peter.
Piggly Wiggly.
Yeah.
This is before Piggly. This is like cement pond stuff. This is great.
Okay. She said the Piggly Wiggly. Piggly Wiggly was big down in the South. I lived in Albuquerque.
Really, it's still happening. It's still
is it really?
Yes, in the South.
A major chain.
Yes,
I did not know
it was a major chain.
Yes,
I did not know that.
But that song was great. It was. I love that the hook was the king of R&B. Ribs and barbecue.
Mm-hmm. Right there when Luther was standing right there. King of R&B.
King of R&B.
Ribs and barbecue. Stuff she was smoking.
Mm-hmm. They said the Piggly Wiggly's still around, y'all.
It is. It's in the South. Yeah. Mimi's right. It's in the South.
And then Sheila says, popcorn still works. According to Sheila, you get time and weather.
That's what?
Now,
minute.
We're all going to try it. We're all going to have to try
They put down popcorn about 10 years ago, maybe a little longer than that. But yeah, they because I tried to call it recently to tell some kids about it, and we laughed about it. And then I found something on YouTube that actually plays it.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah. But unless they change the number, it's
she
no
got
longer
the 415. She said it's 415-726 something.
I'm scared. Okay. It is somebody.
It's got to be 767 because it's POP.
Oh, 767. Yeah.
Jerry, go in the closet real quick. I hate to ask you to go back in the closet. Go in the closet.
Oh,
one of your phones.
I'm a little busy right now, Russman. Right as soon as we're done.
Fair enough.
We'll do a Zoom call just for that.
Zoom call.
Just for that.
Jerry, they are lit in the comments. Shout out to everybody that is watching.
Yes,
make sure you hit the hearts. We want to see some hearts and some thumbs up on Facebook.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And I don't know what you can hit on YouTube, but hit that. Just don't hit the X button. And on Twitter, make sure you share it on Twitter with the hashtag IRTS show.
There you go. Keep it going, CJ Flash. Girl, I got a secret. See if you can guess. Put your heart into the problem and you pass the test. It's a natural occurrence, but one in one makes two. And if I've been acting crazy, that's just one more clue. I see you. Oh, feelings start to shake. Do a double take. Let's get it. Okay, I don't know that one.
Oh, wow.
Talk about it. Go ahead.
I know that record very well, simply because at the time that this record came out, this is 1985, is how I remember it. Me and this group called the UFOs were in LA boogalooing on Venice Beach, and some people came by. This is what they used to do, is they pass out flyers and stuff, and people came by with flyers on Sunday. They were going to shoot the My Secret video at the Forum.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, we didn't go. But
what? Why?
Because we were trying to make money, man. They wasn't paying us. We was at Venice Beach trying to get it in. So, we didn't go. Of course, we wanted to because we were fired up to be in L.A.
Yeah.
But you know, it was like, nah. Y'all can stay out here.
All right.
So if you were to be in the video, CJ, what boogaloo move would you have made?
I don't know. I might have done a little. Just a little bit.
Okay.
You can do that at the drop of a hat.
I have a question for the panel.
Okay.
What video were you invited to be in that you didn't do that you regret?
I don't regret it.
I think her name was Kardashian. I couldn't pronounce it at the time. Kardashian.
You were in her video, Jerry?
Yeah, he was a stunt double for Ray J.
I declined. Which, there's a lot of jokes we could say about that, but I'm not going to do that.
Yeah, we're not going to go there. We're not going to go there. Thank God. Yeah, I was invited to Players Holiday.
Oh, wow.
But I'm glad I did not go.
Okay.
Yeah, I was a little young for that crowd.
I was invited to Pumps in the Bump. And
hey, are you in that video?
No, I'm not.
Truth, Tracy.
Wardrobe.
No. You the lime green bathing suit?
Wardrobe.
No, it was
Pumps in the Bump.
I was actually in a video, a jazz video for Joyce Cooling. You guys know Joyce Cooling?
Okay.
Guitar player. She did a Christmas video that I was in up at Union Square.
Nice.
Amazing. And you guys know more than me how long it takes to do a 3-minute video. Good Lord.
Yeah.
So I was just one of the guys, you know, drinking the hot chocolate around the tree and doing this. And
remember Tony Oakland Stroke?
Yep.
Yeah.
I think I don't know. I don't remember how that worked out. I know I was there. I don't know if I was in it, though.
Hmm. Wow. I bet you're in there.
I was invited to be in the Humpty Hump video and I declined.
Oh, my
goodness. No, I had to.
You keep breaking my heart.
It was imperative that I decline.
Okay.
There's a whole story behind it. I'll tell you guys one day.
We'll get to that one.
Yeah.
Russ. Well,
what about
you,
Russ? Yeah. What about you?
I was working with a group there called Premier at the time that was on Tommy and Denny's label. Mm-hmm. And we were in New Orleans the day that KRS-One was shooting Step Into the World. I didn't think I should take these. Well, their parents were with us also, and I didn't want to take them to the show. I wanted to lead them and go to that video. That was a big regret because I loved that song. I didn't know what song it was when hey, we're doing a KRS-One video down at the theater. You should come. I said, I'm gonna go, and I can't leave. And then later on, I saw all my boys in the video. I was like,
Oh man.
That was
in New Orleans, right?
It was.
Were you there? Sheila the Diva says people think that I'm in the juvenile. Says it's not her. Well,
Sheila. Yeah, right, Sheila. Oh,
I got some jokes for that, Sheila.
Welcome to the moment.
Oh, yeah. Girl,
you look good. 99 and a 2000.
Right.
He went from dialing popcorn to being in the back of that thing in video.
Okay. Girl, you
look
good.
She is spanning the globe right now.
But are you in the vax that thing up? Video, uh-huh. Sheila, yeah. Let us know. Put it in the chat.
I wonder how much they paid him to do that, or how much he took for them to do that, or whatever it was. You know,
it
wasn't enough. It wasn't enough.
Not close to being enough.
Right.
Let's
squeeze in one more song before commercial break. Yes, how about please. That? Go ahead, CJ.
You don't remember me, but I remember you. Was not so long ago, you broke my heart in two. Tears on my pillow, pain in my heart caused by you.
See, his voice is changing a little bit now. It's starting to change a little bit.
You're right.
I want to say he had a part in a slick down.
I'm pretty sure you're right about that. Yeah, pretty sure you're right about that.
So that
were you crushing on him?
I think I was still crushing on him. I didn't care about that part.
You're about
She's
that.
Still
okay.
crushing on Ralph.
I'm right about now, that Ralph today. Life.
Today.
Oh, speaking of Ralph, hold on, Tracy. You see what I got there with Ralph?
Here's on my.
Pillow. You see it? Let me do it.
Ralph, don't do me.
Boom.
Oh, Ralph Tresvant.
Yes.
Okay.
Wow. Look at
got my shirt on, but I still got my
she
shirt
dove.
On.
Look at
G-Dove. G-Dove in there.
That was when Ralph was staying in Fremont for a little while. Remember
Is that?
That
right?
He
no.
Staying, yeah, there, no. He was staying with Hammer for a while.
Yeah.
While
he was
trying to
he
get himself together.
Hammer, but he was being managed by his management company.
By Busted okay. Management?
Yeah, Busted Management. Management?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Very, very pleasant client to work with.
Wow.
Nice.
That's great to hear.
And I concealed my crush. I was very professional.
Good for you.
Mr. Tresvant, is there anything else we can assist you with?
Right.
Put on
oh, my secret.
And then I go back in my office. Oh my God.
Oh, girl.
Oh.
No, that's okay, Tracy. Thank you, baby.
Okay. He was, oh my God. So charismatic.
Wow.
So Russ, you said that album didn't work, huh?
Simply
because,
not.
You know why? Because they had no emotional attachment to any of the songs that they did.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it believe it or not, it really came through on the music. And it just was a poor it was just a poor performance compared to what they had set this bar up. Mm-hmm. You know, they were the next. And this just was so insincere. It just there was no connection at all.
It was like a growing pain, so to speak.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
You had a hodgepodge of different hands in the pot and trying to force them to go pop.
Mm-hmm.
And so they, you know, they're like, "Oh, you need some elevator music." And you didn't
without realizing that they were already popular.
Right.
Right. Know? Right.
You had others from all over the globe trying to figure out who they were.
Right.
Now you want to go pop, but just do what you do.
And trying to be them later on.
Yeah.
So,
right.
Yeah. Right. Still trying to be them.
Right. Right.
Still trying to be them.
Yes.
Yeah.
Harry Como gets a mention.
Who knew? He never expected
Chuck
that.
E. Cheese and Perry Como. When I woke up this morning, I didn't think I was going to hear those words on the show.
We got ears up in here.
Who'd have thunk it? All right, wow. So look, let's think about all of that while we're during this commercial break, and we're going to be back with more of this exciting, fun show. It's IRTS Live. We're talking about New Edition and everybody connected to them. We'll be back in a minute and a half or so.
IRTS Live is I Remember That Song Live. IRTS Live is music, plus conversation, plus education, plus fun. Join us every Tuesday at 7 p.m. Pacific. Watch the IRTS Live team talk about music from your favorite artists. And we've got celebrity guests, too. Created and hosted by Jerry Dove and joined by a team of the industry's finest. Put IRTS Live in your favorites right now, and we'll see you next Tuesday at 7. IRTS Live is brought to you by United Players. It takes the hood to save the hood. Lifelong Medical Care, offering free vaccines for everyone 12 and over. Call Lifelong at 510-549-5454 or visit lifelongmedical.org. C-Dove HR Consulting Group, the human resources specialist, providing personalized service to building a better tomorrow. Enjoy the difference. This episode is powered by PlushLifeMedia.com. Let us remix your digital presence. Hey, we've got gear. Visit IRTSShow.com for coffee cups, caps, t-shirts, and just added IRTS Live mouse pad. Founded by our own Ryan Nicole. Check out Haven, a cultural media production and distribution initiative for housing justice. Find out more at HavenProjectOakland.com. Join DJs Big Russ and CJ Flash for the world-famous show live Fridays, noon to 4 Pacific. Catch them on the following social media platforms. And if you'd like to join us as a sponsor, please email us at info@IRTSShow.com.
Welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. You're watching IRTS Live because it's Tuesday, and because it's Tuesday, you're watching IRTS Live. We appreciate it. Thank you very much for that. We're talking about New Edition and everybody that's connected with them and all the different memories. That this is a perfect topic for this show because all the different conversations and mentions and ideas that have come off of talking about New Edition is exactly what this show is supposed to be all about. Now, Tracy, you got your thing with that entertainment news. You're going to tell us all the what's been going on and the who's been doing what's and the how's. And the...
It's been a lot of
entertainment news. Go ahead.
It's been a lot of goings on, you know, in the field of entertainment. So I'm going to try to run through this as fast as I can because, we, you know, last week we didn't do it, but there were some things that I wanted to kind of mention. So you guys, and I know that Ryan Nicole will appreciate this, but my boo, John Forte, is out of jail.
Yay!
Yay! And I didn't know he was out of jail, but not only is he out of jail, but he is talking about a new solo album called Full Circle, and he's going to be working with the Fugees. So with all the Fugee talk that's been going on, I'm very, very interested to hear what he's going to be writing about. And he looks amazing. Amen?
Amen.
He looks amazing. We touched on this a little bit last week. Tina Turner has sold her music rights to BMG in a blockbuster deal. And I've been hearing numbers floating around, and I heard something to the tune of maybe $50 million, which I don't think is enough, but I can't really, you know, do a solid quote on that. But, you know, she's selling her shares of her recording. She's her writing, publishing shares, neighboring rights, the use of her name and likeness. So I don't know. I feel a way about it, but she's at that stage in her life where she just wants to simplify. So I get that. So we give our very best to the queen, the diva, Tina Turner. We love you. Continued health to you, beautiful lady. I don't know. Have you guys seen this film?
Not yet.
Okay. All right. Well, it's coming out on Netflix, and it's co-produced by Jay-Z. You know, along with James Lasseter and some other people, and starring Regina King and Idris Elba, and just a whole line of amazing, amazing, gifted, talented people. I heard that Jay-Z is doing the majority of the soundtrack, which is very interesting.
Wow.
And they say it's so good that he could possibly look at an Oscar nomination for his work on this for, 2022. So you guys, make sure you support this film as well as the soundtrack when it comes out. But then, in related news... Beyonce has one of the strongest songs on the King Richard movie. Mm. And if you guys aren't aware, Will Smith is playing the infamous father of Serena and Venus. Mm-hmm. And so this is a very powerful film. And Beyonce has, I don't know if it's the lead title or the end title of this amazing movie. But what would happen is, and there's rumors flying around that song would be nominated for an Oscar.
Wow.
So this year, if this happens, that would be the first time a husband and wife would go against each other for Oscar nominations. Wow. So as this season kicks up, you know, with the Oscars, we'll talk about it more, you know, as things solidify. But that would be a very historic and interesting scenario to watch. So shout out to to Jay-Z and Beyonce. That would be amazing, right?
Yeah.
Here we have the picture in a Tiffany ad. So Beyonce, I like Tiffany, okay? I like Tiffany. And if you get, you know, some little extra rings, yellow diamonds or something, you can go on and fling them this way. You know, she's interested in it. In a more somber note, we want to say rest in peace to Dion Estes. Dion Estes, amazing musician who, you know, did a lot of work with Wham in the 80s, and also had a solo career. He had a couple of songs that I liked a lot, and so we just lost him on Monday, and so we just want to say rest in peace to this amazing, amazing creative. And peace to his family and circle of friends.
Yeah.
We're just doing a little preliminary discussion here. We'll be talking about this as the countdown begins to the Super Bowl in February. I was shocked. I was shocked when I saw this. I you know, for so many reasons, right, Ryan? It's like so many reasons. I'm sure we all have strong opinions about it, and I'm so interested to hear how we all feel about it as we count down. But Dr. Dre, Snoop Dogg, Mary J. Blige, Eminem, okay, and just come on, and Kendrick Lamar, this is going to be epic, I already know. So we'll be talking about it as we go forward. Usher has a brand new baby right here, Castrello Raymond, so congratulations out to our very own Usher Raymond, beautiful, you know, he shared. And this Sunday, you guys, versus
Sunday,
6 p.m. Pacific time. My baby daddy, and the teacher, the one and only teacher, KRS-One. This is going to be an epic battle. Not sure how I feel about it. I want to hear from CJ and Russ on this matchup. But that's happening this Sunday, you guys, on Instagram. So make sure you tune into that. And that's all we have for the entertainment segment. I'm sorry if I took too long, but it was too much work. And if you want to follow me, you can on all the platforms at Plush Life Media. All the platforms.
We got a choreography there.
We did. We killed it. It was
So that's it, you guys, for this week. Thank you for your patience.
That was great. Can I add one more thing?
Yeah.
Have you guys seen Nick Cannon's new show?
No.
That comes on 11 a.m. Channel 2 Fox.
Oh,
he does it in Harlem, I guess, in the old 106 and Park City.
Yeah, boycotting Channel 2.
Ah.
What happened?
I don't know. Because of
Frank Summer. Frank Somerville.
Yeah. Right. Nobody sent me a memo. We want to support Nick Cannon, so
I'm
about the show.
The show.
Yeah, what is it?
I've always been a fan of Nick Cannon. I've liked him since he was a kid on Nickelodeon. The show it reminds me of those movies that you would see about a talk show. He comes out and the audience is singing, and then they get the cam thing going, and then they get the dance, and it's just really, 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 really silly. And it's just really forced. He's making the audience do an awful lot of work. But I like Nick. The good thing about it is it's kind of Arsenio Hall-ish, where he's getting guests on that you couldn't see on any other show.
That's cool.
You get to see some brown and black and brown faces that nobody else is putting on TV. So he's on at 11 o'clock on a station to be
The animal station. Right. Yeah.
Just see what you think. Watch it for a few days, and maybe we can talk about it next week and see what you think. But
nice.
I'm a big fan.
He's done a good job of putting on for, you know, a lot of artists that wouldn't have otherwise gotten shine. Yes. Amanda Seals credits him with a boost in her career. Kehlani, you know, from here, from the Bay, he really put her on. He's a good behind the scenes cat.
Yeah.
And I know he's a dad several times over this past year. So
He said he's got like 11 kids or something like that.
Yeah, he got a squad.
And then this is his bit. He said that he's going to be celibate for the rest of 2021.
Oh, boy.
Good luck.
Let's see how that works out with cuffing season right here on the coast.
Okay, yeah. It's all cold outside.
It's cold outside, Nicholas.
Maybe it's cold.
But you know,
wrap it up with a turban, bro. Wrap it up with a turban.
Oh, but I will say that void of Arsenio Hall is so felt.
Oh, yeah.
If there was anybody who could really feel that void because of the fact that he's so likable and that he really likes the talent, you know, I think he could feel that void. So let's see what happens.
All right, Nicholas.
Yeah, get a look, everybody out there, and let us know what you think next week or give it a couple of weeks or whatever, and we'll bring it up again, see what you think.
Word.
But that was great, Tracy. Very good. Thank you very much.
Thank you,
Trace. CJ Flash, you are up. It's IRTV. I remember that video. What you got for us?
This video needs no introduction.
But you can see it in my eyes. So don't deny, I can't fool no one else. The truth is in the tears I cry. 'Cause if it isn't love, why do I feel this way? Why does she stay on my mind? And if it isn't love, why does it hurt so bad? Make me feel so sad inside. If it isn't love.
I love that.
Oh, choreography. That. Come on now.
I love the way those guys just glide across the floor.
They were just so professional. You could, all of their years of experience just oozed out with ease in a rehearsal, you know? That's one of my favorite songs from them and one of my favorite videos.
Yeah, definitely one of my favorite videos of all time.
Circling back, Doc Ice would have fit in beautifully.
Right there.
Oh, get down. Doc Ice is a beast on the stage.
He is a cluster on the stage. That would be amazing.
Now, I know you said you professed your love for Ralph, and Ryan has professed her opposite of love for Johnny. And most of the ladies I talk to say that they love Ronnie DeVoe.
Ooh, Ronnie's the one.
They love
Ronnie's the one. Yeah. Ageless Ronnie.
Yeah.
For some reason, everybody got a thing for Ronnie.
He's tall.
Yeah. He's fine.
And he stays in shape.
He does.
Excellent.
He stays in shape.
And he might be the best dancer in the group too, right?
I wouldn't doubt it. Yeah, he gets it in.
And Ralph. Yeah, definitely, you know.
Yeah, they up there.
Yeah. But Ronnie looks amazing. You know, he's in his 50s. And like I said, takes amazing care. He might be on the same diet you are, CJ, where y'all just go, hey, what's up?
Might be.
Yeah. Baby tears.
Okay.
Okay. Great video. Go ahead, CJ, hit another song for us.
All right.
Yeah. You say you want to be the one I need. You say you want to be the one for me. You say you want to be the one I need. But then you go and act so crazy. You say you never want to let me go. You say you want to be the one I hold. You say you never want to let me go. But then you go and leave me lonely.
A little bit of love got a long way.
Yeah.
is.
That's that 107.7 crowd. That's what that song was for. It wasn't really for KMEL. It was more for like KSOL or whatever at that time, which is now 94.9. But you know, that whole San Jose crowd. But it was a banger nonetheless.
Yeah.
I think vocally it was really produced well. I thought it was a great performance, you know. And yeah, I
like
it.
I did too. It's all fun. Right.
Mm-hmm. Russell?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, I'm here for this entire era of New Edition. It was, I don't know anybody my age that did not have one, if not two, cassette copies of the Heartbreak. You know, it was just, it was one of those albums that was, that summer, there were two albums that were just the best albums you could ever imagine. It was Any Heartbreak, and it was Songs from the Big Chair. Those two albums, they ran the streets.
Yeah.
And it was one of those things. This is back in the day when you had, it mattered whether or not there were songs on both sides of the album. It mattered how the album was sequenced and how it was put together. To find a weak link in the album, you had to search for a weak link. There were very few songs on that album that you fast forward. It had layers. They all hit people in different pockets. You had guys learning how to learn words to all the slow songs.
Yes.
You had guys, you know, learning the dance moves and the videos. It was just nuts. It was their moment. That moment, that album right there, that was their Abbey Road,
there I believe. Is. Yeah.
Even though they had a considerable hit with their debut, that album was their Abbey Road. And I say that because of the way it affected the consumer and the industry.
Yeah. So, Russ, did you get a moped?
No, I did not have a moped. No. But I did not have a moped, but I did have some of those Capizio espadrilles. I did have some. Wow.
Did you have stirrup pants, though?
I had no stirrup pants. I'm too big for stirrup pants.
But you had a Capizio.
They would take me to the loony bin if I had some stirrup pants.
Going on.
There was so much on that record.
In E Heartbreak.
Yes. Yes. It was so much. And Tracy touched on it earlier with Boys to Men. The layers, this was a grown up record. And they killed it.
Yeah.
And the fact that they were performers all this time, and Johnny was a kid performer as well, they could duplicate these songs on stage.
Yes.
This tour, believe it or not, they toured with this record opening up for Bobby.
Wow. I didn't know that.
And then it actually changed midway.
Okay. If he flipped.
This record, this was a phenomenal record.
Wow. Yeah, nice. No doubt.
Nice.
I agree.
All right, so let's recap then. We've had a Perry Como, Chuck E. Cheese, and an Abbey Road.
Yes.
All on the show tonight. That's what I'm talking about.
I hope I'm not overstating it. It's just, I know for a fact.
It was their best.
It was worthy of that. It was definitely a seamless bridge for their level of maturity that they had to go into.
Yeah.
And it didn't feel contrived. It didn't feel like weird. You know, sometimes when kid groups grow up, it's like, okay, it's kind of weird.
Yeah.
It was not an awkward moment. It was seamless. And it was really good music.
I agree.
It was really good music and well produced,
I thought.
The content was spot on. The content was spot on. And I want to talk a little bit about the video. One of the things that I get a kick out of, you know, we're blessed to be able to play concerts, and we play a lot of old school music at concerts. One of the things that we do that I really, really have a lot of fun with is when I'll be in the crowd and CJ will play If It Isn't Love, and I will have him stop the record and I'll look for somebody in the audience that's already doing the video.
Yes.
And I'll do a contest for somebody who can do the entire video.
Yes.
And it's usually a grown ass man that is nailing every step.
Full choreo.
Every step. Yes. And it is so much fun. And it's just an engaging moment for the audience. You got 12, 15, 22,000 people just remembering that video. And it takes a special piece of art that can do that.
Yeah.
And really, when you think about that video, it was such a good teaser ad almost for just the process to create such a record. Their process as a group, you know, we see the finished product of perfection, you know, but they really work very hard. You know, Brooke Payne was not easy on those guys growing up, even as young adults. And so we saw, it was like, now we're so used to the behind the scenes voyeurism, you know, that we have on social media. At that time, it wasn't really prevalent. So that was almost like a backstage, you know, peek of their process. And so it's just an important video.
Which was brilliant because we hadn't seen them since, you know, under the Blue Moon. Under the Blue Moon, we hadn't seen them at all.
And
there was a lot of internal problems, and we were hearing all the scuttlebutt in Light On magazine, and you know, the backstage of Jet, the backstage of Jet.
So
this writing that down to scuttlebutt.
Right, scuttlebutt. That's a highbrow word.
IRTS bingo.
Yeah. So this is whoever can spell it. Fantastic. It's a pen.
Brilliant, brilliant marketing re-entry. Brilliant.
Yes, I agree. And on top of that, I don't want to, you know, do too much, but their look really matured and individualized. You know, there's a different look for each gentleman, but they all were polished. They went from being kind of like your dudes on the corner is what they kind of look like, you know, into looking like these really polished superstars that everybody wanted to emulate.
Ricky was doing push-ups. It was all good.
Video. And, you know, they talked about Ralph's stirrup pants, but they worked for me.
They worked for a lot of people because a lot of brothers had on stirrup pants, okay?
No, not a lot of brothers.
Yes, they did. They
worked for Tracy.
Over three here.
They worked for Tracy and Gene Anthony Ray. That was the only two people they worked for.
Unless you was playing baseball, you wasn't wearing no stirrup pants.
Yeah. That's what y'all saying.
He didn't give up that Gene Anthony Ray at all. I didn't get that.
Okay, I'm going to ask you a question right now. Brother comes to your house rocking some stirrup pants
today. Right.
Brother came to your house. No, this is
y'all had biker short suits. So
yes,
you know
we
you
did. I will say a lot of brothers did embarrass the hell out of themselves wearing some 7-Eleven biker shorts. Yes, we did.
7-Eleven.
But they drew the line at the stirrup pants and the capizios. It was not happening.
Yeah. It worked for
Come
me.
Come on, Tracy. You lying. You're lying right now.
I'm not lying.
You're lying. You are so lying. Blair Underwood came to your door with some stirrup pants on. You would Blair swipe Underwood whichever wanted. Direction was wrong. You would swipe it right now.
Okay. You're right. I'm not lying, though, for the record. Ralph was the only person who could get away was walking up on me with some stirrup pants.
That was because
a wardrobe experiment.
That was all.
It worked.
Okay. I'm writing that down too. That's a bingo card in the middle there.
There we go, Valerie. Valerie won.
Conversation.
Scuttlebutt.
CJ Flash, you got some more music?
Yep.
Let's hear it.
Everybody sing it for me. Yeah.
Brian, I'm gonna make you talk about Johnny Gill first.
Oh, Johnny. just blowing out his voice, exploding his carotid artery, just doing the most. I don't know. I have a love-hate situation with Johnny.
Really?
But I just like him to pull back. That's all. It's a lot for me sometimes. I saw him it's funny because I saw him in Harlem at the Harlem Street Fest, and everybody was hyped to have him. And you know, he started his songs and then he did like that guttural scream for all the songs. And I was like, bruh, like fall back. Just do the dang song already. You don't have to scream. We know you can sing, my guy. We know you can sing.
I will agree with you there. He doesn't sing the songs anywhere close to the record.
No.
You know, and too many runs and too many runs. And just like you said, just chill out and just sing the song.
Just give us a song, baby. Yeah, Johnny,
we love you. Okay, we do love you,
Jonathan.
He has something to prove.
Yeah.
When you see him perform live, which is not the case. It's so far from the case. When you see him perform live now, he plays 7 different instruments on stage.
That's dope.
He got a full band right there. He don't have to do that.
He gonna play the flute and the clarinet.
He plays bongos. He plays guitar. He plays the drums. He did a whole solo on a triangle. He's just trying to prove a point, and I don't get it.
Yeah.
But he really is very, very talented.
He's very gifted.
He'll take his signature songs like My. You can go put more money in the meter, come back. He hadn't even got to the third my yet.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I think it's the shoulder shimmy and the grunt. That's the only one. The shoulder shimmy and the grunt. But that daggone rub you the right way.
The rub the right way is the band. Yeah,
Jimmy Jam, Terry Lewis.
Listen, the production on most of the jams are fire.
Yeah. Yeah.
But he will do too much on them, is my point.
And he sweat like Patrick Ewing. He does sweat like Patrick Ewing.
We still love you, Johnny. But
I love Brother Death. I love Brother Death. He sweat like Patrick Ewing.
He's moist.
Like
he's moist.
And moist. But listen, that rub you the right way. I got you. I'm with you on that, Johnny. Okay. No more shoulder shimmies. It's okay.
All right, Flash, we got time for maybe 2-3 more songs, and that's about it. So let's see what we can squeeze in.
Okay.
I got to do this. Look at this one.
Can't sweat during the COVID.
Oh my goodness. Sweat flings.
Right.
Loving the folks out there watching tonight.
Get out the baby showers.
You sweating on everybody, Johnny.
Yeah, you sweating all on the cupcakes, man.
Okay, crucial.
Yes, that's a jam.
Crucial Loving. What's the combo on that album? Go ahead.
That's just another hit from that album.
Mm-hmm.
You going five hits deep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
At least 1, 2, 3, 6.
Six wow.
Hits. Okay.
Hits.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Nice. Album hit from the start to the finish, huh?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Side A, side B.
Yeah. All right.
Keep it going, CJ Flash.
Girl, you are right, baby, so my body, my head is alive. crazy. I really don't care. That's my prerogative. They say I'm nasty, but I don't give a damn. Getting girls is how I live. Some ask the questions, why am I so real? But they don't understand me. I really don't know the deal about a brother. Trying hard to make it right. Not long ago, before I've been despised. So
everybody's talking all the stuff about me. Why don't they just let me live?
Tell me why.
I don't need permission to make my own decisions. Oh. That's my prerogative.
It's my
prerogative. It's driving me out of my mind. That's why it's hard for me to find. Can't get it. Kiss her, love her. That girl is
poison. You never trust a big button to smile.
I'm tired.
Ooh, yeah. You said you're tired.
I want myself low.
Okay, okay, oh, Jerry. I see you.
There, my mic's off. There we go. There we go.
Hey. Nice guy. I mean, show that again, Jerry. That was you.
Show that again. You like that?
That was BBDG.
You are absolutely right.
That's dope.
They look
nice guys. Really nice guys.
They do look great.
You know, kids that grew up in this industry do not fare as well as these guys have had. Obviously, they've had some things happen, right?
Mm-hmm.
But they're still alive to tell it all, and they look amazing. They look amazing, and I cannot wait until the world opens up again so I could get all of those guys on the stage and enjoy a show. And I have the privilege of having an autograph picture with everybody, including Johnny.
Oh, wow.
Including Bobby.
Wow.
All six of them?
All of them.
Wow,
man,
all of them. So
that's an NFT. You can sell that. Yeah, yeah.
One of the best concerts I've ever been to was when all six of them were together, because it was like five shows in one. You got New Edition, you got BBD, you got Johnny, you got Ralph, and you got what am I missing? Johnny, Ralph,
Bobby.
All of them. And they would break out, come back together, break out. It was an amazing show.
Was that the one at the Oakland Coliseum?
Exactly.
That was the night that Bobby Brown showed me that he can really like sing soulfully. And he covered, and we talked about this before, but he covered All Is Fair in Love. Stevie Wonder's All Is Fair.
I remember,
Did he?
Oh my God. I had never seen him. I've seen people cover that song, but I didn't expect him to do it.
Yeah,
and he was so honest, and it was so it was so genuine from where he was coming from. And if he didn't crack, he didn't. He was right on point, and he knocked it out of the park. It was amazing. Amazing.
You know, another moment like that, CJ, is when he did Sammy Davis Jr.
Right,
Davis Jr. performance, and that's when you looked at Bobby like, wow, okay,
he's
really, really talented.
He did that at a Whitney's concert, right?
Yeah, it was a, I don't know if it was an award show, it was something where
Whitney was involved. Was beautiful, I agree.
I was impressed,
powerful.
We're working a whole nother bingo card now with the Sammy Davis Jr. mention on IRTS. The range is amazing. The range of the show is amazing.
We can go there.
Fantastic. Any last thoughts on New Edition?
It's just that every producer has touched them. Every producer who was, you know, who meant something at, at an era have touched them, and they've been able to as the guys have been able to craft songs that really work and really highlight those producers' abilities. I just wanted to name that, because that set you just played, CJ, was you know, like the beginning of a beautiful showcase of a production suite, you know? Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And they're so rare. They dance, they can rap, they can sing, and they were so relevant to that time period. I think they represented us really well. Obviously, we've had a lot of different male groups since then, right?
Yeah.
But New Edition really was the standard after the Jackson 5. You know, and also had a ripple effect into the pop community, you know, with Kids on the Block and, you know, all the other groups that came out. So, you know, I just want to say if they happen to see this, thank you for representing us, you know, and giving us little girls something to be excited about.
Yeah.
It wasn't a whole lot at that time.
No.
And they filled a major void and really enriched my childhood. So shout out to you guys.
Yeah.
And they enriched my adulthood. once got to that level, they enriched my adulthood.
Yeah.
So all right, look.
There's rumors of a Vegas residency next year.
I'm here.
So I trip, y'all. What you think?
I'm here for it. Let's go.
Trip. That's easy.
Yeah.
Let's tell you what. I mean, we keep talking about this for real, though. If we all get there, I'll buy the tickets for the show. How about that?
All right, Gerald.
I'll buy the tickets for the show. And I might even, you know, we're in Vegas. I'm going to get the dinner, too.
Okay.
You got to get there.
Jared, I have front row seats, so
easy turbo, easy turbo.
We'll get there. We'll fly Spirit, and by fly I mean, you know, just lift slightly off the ground and hold on.
If they come to Vegas, then that's on me. I got y'all.
All right.
Or hell, if they come here, I'll buy the tickets for that.
Even better, Sheila Diva, you heard it. You heard it here.
Yes.
All right.
I wrote it down on my notes here.
All right.
All right. So really quickly, let's go around the horn and see what everybody's doing so we can wrap this up and get on to watching some sports activities tonight. So Ryan, since you're talking there, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm in the San Francisco Bay Area Theater Company's New Roots Theater Festival this weekend coming. In a play called Shining, which is a revision of a Greek mythology on Phaeton. So that's happening. We're doing four shows, one at 1 o'clock, one at 5:30. I believe those are the times. We're doing that Saturday and Sunday. So come through. It's going to be the last time I'm on stage until I have this baby. So come on out, catch a girl.
Come on out.
Three shows in one day, you said?
Four shows, two shows in a day, four shows over the weekend.
Wow,
it's going to be great. Yeah. It's going to be great.
Pace yourself.
Yeah, I'm not going to be doing a whole lot. Okay. I'll be on stage a lot, but I won't be doing the most, if that makes sense. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Tracy?
All right. Well, yesterday I did a big giveaway on my IG at Plush Life Media. And we gave away $510. It was sponsored. But it was very, very fun to give that away. I do giveaways often. So if you're not following me, make sure you follow me at Plush Life Media on all platforms. All the platforms.
There you go.
But it was so fun. It went to a really deserving entrepreneur who is amazing. In fact, I'm wearing her shirt today.
Oh, wow.
Unapologetically Irie. She's a friend of mine, Jamaican, and she's amazing. So you can, I think the website is Unapologetically Irie on the internet streets. But she's dope. And I gave her $510. So I'm happy.
You're dope. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was your birthday, but everybody else got the presents.
You said what?
It was your birthday, but everybody else got the presents.
Wow.
Yes. But the blessings, you know, in exchange. I'm healthy and in my right mind and on here with amazing musical geniuses. So my blessings, I've gotten them.
Amanda. All right, Russ and CJ. Yo. Let's talk about some DJ stuff. What you got going on?
Oh, good Lord. We're gearing up for this Friday. I'll be hanging out. Playing music and fielding requests and having fun.
For the extravaganza, right?
The extravaganza.
So where is it all going to be? So
it's very interesting. We kind of got narrowed down, and this wasn't our fault, but we kind of got narrowed down to two platforms now. So now it's just Facebook and Mixcloud. Somehow, IG, I don't know if we got blocked, but we haven't been able to get back on IG.
Wow.
Twitch had some issues with folks in the raid parties, and there were racial raid parties that they were doing. So we backed out of that. Yeah, it was really strange. But they've also changed their music policies. So now they're cracking down on DJs, and that's going to be very interesting. So Twitch is kind of null and void at this point. So now we're down to two. Periscope folded. So now Twitter has not set up where you could do live just yet. They're still working on it. So we're down to two platforms, is Facebook and Mixcloud. Mixcloud is the main one that we're on. It's uninterrupted, and it's a lot of fun. So
I think Twitter may be, I heard some rumblings this week that they are active.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, so I think, in which I miss Periscope. I was one of those Periscope OGs.
Yeah, Periscope was fun.
But,
Yeah.
All right, Russ, what you got?
What he said.
Okay, well, I will just say this, that I'm going to Atwater again on Sunday. My mom is having some surgery on Monday. All I would ask is that everybody here and everybody listen, send some prayers out my way for me. Mrs. Gladys Dove. She will be just fine, but you know, all the prayers we can give will just help us all.
So I'll give you a full report for the doctors, praying for the doctors who, you know, she's under, and making sure that their hands are blessed as she gets through, praying for a speedy recovery.
Doctors, nurses,
Dominus, Dominus Omnis. Take it All right, so that's it. That's another great episode of IRTS Live. I hope you guys all enjoyed it. Looks like we did.
Yes.
We are going to be back next week with another episode, and we will see you then. It's IRTS Live. Peace.
Peace.
IRTS Live is brought to you by United Players. It takes the hood to save the hood. Lifelong Medical Care, offering free vaccines for everyone 12 and over. Call Lifelong at 510-549-5454 or visit lifelongmedical.org. C-Dove HR Consulting Group, the human resources specialist, providing personalized service to building a better tomorrow. Enjoy the difference. This episode is powered by PlushLifeMedia.com. Let us remix your digital presence. Hey, we've got gear. Visit IRTSShow.com for coffee cups, caps, t-shirts, and just added IRTS Live mouse pad. Founded by our own Ryan Nicole. Check out Haven, a cultural media production and distribution initiative for housing justice. Find out more at havenprojectoakland.com. Join DJs Big Russ and CJ Flash for the world-famous show live Fridays, noon to 4 Pacific. Catch them on the following social media platforms. And if you'd like to join us as a sponsor, please email us at info@irtsshow.com.